Io vivat, io vivat nostrorum sanitas, hoc est amoris populum doloris est antidotum. Io vivat, io vivat nostrorum sanitas. Io vivat, io vivat nostrorum sanitas. Dum nihil est in populo iam repleatur de nuo. Io vivat, io vivat nostrorum sanitas. Io vivat, io vivat nostrorum sanitas. Nos incit amicitia, et vinum praebet gaudia. Io vivat, io vivat nostrorum sanitas.
Fit moet je zijn. How fit must one be? Educational fitness. Dear Rector, members of the Executive Board, Deans and Professors of Eindhoven University of Technology, dear Boards of the various Student Associations of Eindhoven, dear members of the University Council, dear attendees, it is with great honor that I welcome you to the opening convocation of the 2012-2013 academic year. A special welcome goes to our guest speakers of today, Martin van Pernis, President of the Royal Institute of Engineers, Kiviniria, and Elke Gerards, associate professor at Erasmus University Rotterdam. My name is Mike Wilmer, and I represent both the student workgroup that has helped to organize this event and the Federation of Study Associations Eindhoven, the federation that unifies the common goals and interests of the Eindhoven Student Association for Education. Today's theme is educational fitness. Despite some brilliant remarks that that came from many of the students we spoke to during the promotion for today, I have to disappoint, or maybe for some of you, relieve you. Today is not meant to be a strong physical workout. Today we will discuss what it means to be in optima forma academically, top shape. To be fit for education, both as students and as staff. This university is working continuously to achieve and maintain this top state, which is evident today as we celebrate the introduction of the Bachelor College. First, I would like to invite the rector, Professor Hans van Duin, to make his opening address on educational fitness and the new Bachelor College.
Thank you very much, Mike. I'm a bit taller than you are, so I have to adjust the microphone. Dear students, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the opening ceremony for our university's new academic year. And may I add, to the new year itself. Things are rapidly changing here in Eindhoven. Our Bachelor College and the new buildings, Metaforum and Ceres, are ready to go. So we are eager to get started. And as you will have noticed, we have been doing some gardening outside in front of the building during the summer break. We are still creating that groene lopen, the green carpet, but it's not yet ready. And maybe you have also spotted, it depends on where you were this afternoon, you have spotted our new hot air balloon that we share with industrial partners from this region. Because of all the ongoing construction, going through the air is the best way to cross our campus. But that will be soon over. Anyway, I'm glad you found your way to the entrance today. And here inside, we have, as previous years, again, a very good crowd. Fantastic. Good to see so many of you. In particular, my dear students, mijn grote vrienden en vriendinnen van me. And let me start with the good news. This month, we have more than 1,800 new students on campus. And that is considerably more than last year. In particularly, we have many more women, many more female students, and many more international bachelor students. So our community is becoming more diverse, and that's what we want, because that is a great development. Let me extend a special welcome to the student committee here on the front row. They suggested indeed the theme educational fitness. Because this morning, after a year of very hard work, we started the Bachelor College. And this afternoon, now, we will be looking at the changing role of the engineer in society. And in particularly, how our new educational program will prepare you, students, for your future. Our education aims to make our students fit for life. So the theme, educational fitness, is perfect. And many thanks to the committee, too, for all the hard work you have put into the organization of this event, this ceremony, and tonight's party. Ladies and gentlemen, who better to speak about the role of the engineer than Martin van Pernis, president of our, hear what I say, our Royal Institute of Engineers, the Kiviniria. Martin is the former CEO of Siemens Nederland. He is chairman of Vernieuwing Bouw. He is chairman of Dutch Space. There is much more, and he is even member of the board of Feyenoord Football Club. So, There's nothing to laugh about that. That's a very serious work. So he knows a lot about careers. Martin, Mr. President, welkom en fijn om je hier te hebben. A special welcome also to Elke Gerards. Elke is, was just mentioned, is associate professor at the Institute of Psychology of Erasmus University in Rotterdam. And her research focuses on cognitive processes involved in emotional disorders. The student suggested that we invite her because in 2011, Elke was voted the smartest woman in the Netherlands. So welcome to the smartest region of the world. Okay. Be sure, Elke, that we have some very, very clever women here at TU Eindhoven as well. Eigenlijk, Elke, zouden we jou gewoon hier moeten houden. Ladies and gentlemen, at TU Eindhoven, we are going through a revolution, a big abrupt change regarding our educational system. We have designed majors of 90 credits, electives, keuzevakken, 60 credits, and a common base for all the students of 30 credits. And I will be more specific in a moment. We are giving a much greater emphasis on the social sciences and humanities. And there is a lot of flexibility in the program so that a student can follow a path that fits her or his individual interest and talent. The way we are going to teach changes as well, and this will require a different mindset both for the students and staff. And that is perhaps the biggest challenge we are facing. Compared to the second and third current years, compared to the current second and third year students, our incoming first year students, our freshmen, will be much more responsible for the way they pass through the bachelor. To a large extent, they can design their own program. I'm going to show you a couple of videos, beginning with one featuring students who were involved in the design of the new program. So let's listen to their observations.
I'm now graduating at ASML, and I'm working on a project that has to combine a lot of knowledge from software, from electronics, from mechatronics, from mechanics. And the thing is, they already have really good people in all those fields, and they really make the best solutions. But then if you combine this to a whole, it might still not be an optimal solution. So there is much to gain. And then after that, it's also really important that you can explain to the business guys and to the customers why your new solution is actually better and how you can make money with this. This is really important as well.
We formed a think tank with 12 students from all different studies and student associations. And with our think tank, we came up with solutions to improve the bachelor program from student perspective.
Only when you can combine different disciplines and also the non-technical ones, that you can really make sure that the innovations you think of actually will get realized.
So the new bachelor program is much more flexible to fit into your own interest, and not only in the direction of your master, but also in other skills you want to develop as engineer.
It would be better actually if everybody would have a broad base so that they can talk to people from other disciplines. But after that you have more choice to follow the courses that you think are most interesting for you or that you will use later in your career.
Another benefit of the new bachelor program is that you are able to be actively involved in the courses since you only have 3 courses in parallel.
In this way, we will have more unique types of engineers, and if they all work together, I think this can be way more efficient and way more fun for everybody.
The new Eindhoven engineer is involved, active and happier.
The Eindhoven engineer of the future is multidisciplinary, unique and bright.
Twan is doing a project at ASML, and Nienke is spending a semester, half a year in Australia. These are two very remarkable students. And as they just explained, the new program lets you widen your scope, but also allows you to go into real depth. Our philosophy is to stay close to the students' talents, to give them the best opportunity for their career. There is no such thing as the engineer of the future. There will be all sorts of different engineers with very different profiles. And not only in the traditional fields where engineers have always been active. Engineers no longer strictly work within the field of chemical engineering or physics or mechanical engineering. Increasingly important are the cross connections, the combination of different disciplines, different technologies, the human factor, and entrepreneurial skills. And lots of students are interested in these aspects of a career, but they didn't always find that opportunity here at TU Eindhoven. And that got us thinking about the new program. That is, by the way, also what our government wants us to do, to make our role clearer, to be more specific. Which is why we have chosen to emphasize health, energy, and mobility. These are our strategic areas, strategic not only for us, but for the whole of society as well. Our new educational approach also gives us a clearer role for society. It's worth repeating, ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, that TU Eindhoven is a university and not a research institute. We are here first and foremost to educate young people. Research is needed for that purpose, and that is the correct order. We do a lot of research, of course, but that is instrumental to our education. We need top research in order to deliver top education. And I should add and admit that I wouldn't have said that 7 years ago when I first became rector. It took me really a long time to realize that our primary added value for society is the talent, the skills, and the creativity of our young people, and the knowledge, insight, and enthusiasm that we can pass on. Let's see how some staff members have been working on the new program.
One year ago, when we started to redesign the bachelor program, both the staff and the students, which are already in our universities, were very reluctant. But during time, they became more and more enthusiastic. And I think that is because they saw the room which the bachelor program is giving to all type of students. You can go deeply into your discipline, or you can combine it with whatever motivation and ambitions you have.
That means that it widens the perspective of the students in the sense that they are more aware of the context they will be working in later when they are working as an engineer. Might mean that there will be less time available for the traditional courses like the physics courses, the mathematics courses. On the other hand, there is enough possibility for students to fill this up with the proper choices of the elective courses during the bachelor. And also during the master stage, this can be done in a very effective way.
Until recently, we attracted mainly the intrinsic motivated students who want to be very good in their own discipline and go very deeply. And we still need those students, but we also need engineers who are very innovative in a big company or even want to start their own enterprise.
So we are presently developing a new lecture course in which we are going to apply to use the mathematics in order to do modeling of physical system, of biological system, of societal systems. So this is a very nice way to make mathematics operational in a context that can be very interesting for the future engineer. The Eindhoven engineer is prepared and flexible.
Is top of the bill and followed his ambition to become an engineer of the future.
These are just two members of our staff, but believe me, many, many more have contributed to the new program. And I'm proud of what has been achieved and what has been achieved. You just saw the dean of the college, Lex Lemmens. And Lex, I want to say this here in public. I don't know whether if you're there somewhere, but without your knowledge, your wisdom, Your drive and political skills, we would not have been where we are now. Thank you on behalf of all of us. Starting today, all Eindhoven engineers will be educated according to a common philosophy. We will have one bachelor college for all our undergraduate studies. All students will receive a common base consisting of mathematics, of physics, engineering, design, professional skills, ethics, and history. All that will give them a true all-round basis that is characteristic for the Eindhoven engineer. And on top of that, we have introduced what we call USE, which stands for the User, Society, and Enterprise Perspectives. You, students, will learn to design for a sustainable future. You will learn about the future of mobility. You will learn everything you always wanted to know about patents, about the secret life of light, the role of robots, the role of humans in technology, and much, much more. In short, through USE, our students will learn to relate technology to its users, to societal challenges, and to industry. So altogether, a broad package of skills and knowledge. But of course, the core of the program is your own field, your major. And together with the electives, the keuzevakken, there is now much more flexibility when selecting your subjects, so you can focus more effectively on what is truly important for your own talent, interest, and career. If you want to take differential equations 1, 2, and 3, and who doesn't want to take differential equations 1, 2, and 3, that is possible. But if you want to combine your physics major with management and entrepreneurial topics, that is possible as well. And the way we will do the teaching will be much more intense. Students will have only 3 activities in parallel, generally 2 classes and a project. And we believe, and we copied this from Utrecht University, that this will make it possible to really focus on the classes and the projects. I think it is really a very attractive program. It is, in Nederlands te zeggen, echt hartstikke leuk. En ik wou dat ik het had gehad toen ik hier studeerde. Want ik zou wel alle differentiaalvergelijkingen en stromingsleer bij elkaar gekozen hebben. The first year is now in place, the first part of our fitness machine, and we are currently working on year 2 and year 3. For our post-bachelor education, we have set up the TU Eindhoven Graduate School, which combines all our master, designer, and PhD programs. Once again, students will find it easier to map out their own route within the new structure. And once again, there will be more flexibility and room for the individual choice. The graduate school will also give our university a stronger position and enhanced visibility in attracting international students. So, dear students, we are working on the complete program for your personal fitness. We even have a new fitness studio, which is what I'm going to show you now.
We always looked at this building as a kind of crossroads of the entire university. The elevated walkways that connect all buildings come together exactly at this spot. Ever since it was built, the fun of the way hall was walking the elevated walkways and seeing people working on machines or experiments or models. And now this feeling is back because now you walk on the walkways and you look down and you see people studying or having small conversations or working on their laptops or iPads. For us, this design was always about making connections. Connections between the different departments of the university, between students, between staff and students, but also between the future of the university and the past. After all, the Wey Hall was one of the first buildings that was built on this site, and it's now 50 years after its after completion, it has now a new life as a new center of the university. Everybody enters the building on this first floor level and then goes down into the library, and you will find that once you go down, the atmosphere becomes more quiet and allows you for more concentration on your work. Of course, work can not always be about concentration. So that's why we made this very adventurous and visible staircase right at the heart of the building. It allows you to see your colleagues and to be seen at the same time. We are now in the atrium of the new building for the Department of Mathematics and Computer Science, which is situated right on top of the existing Weihall, the new learning center. So the system of walkways has now also a vertical, a 3D component. The existing Weihall, with its characteristic checkerboard roof structure, was preserved entirely and renovated thoroughly. Its original black structure is now combined with new white columns supporting the building part for mathematics and computer sciences. Together they provide for an interior with a lively and dynamic atmosphere that presents a multitude of interesting perspectives.
Isn't that a spectacular building? We walked through it and we saw all the young people there hanging out. It is really great. You will see it in a moment because that is where we will have our reception. And we are very proud that Joost Ector, that is the architect who designed Metaforum, studied here in Eindhoven. May I have a big applause for Joost. So, ladies and gentlemen, everything is in place. The new fitness studio is open. The instructors are prepared and the personal trainers are ready to go. But now it's your turn, students. Grote vrienden en vriendinnen van me, nu moeten jullie er echt met z'n allen tegenaan. You should grab the chances that are here for you. We have a year ahead of us that is full of opportunities. And we will be there to coach you along the way. But it's your responsibility to work up a sweat, om je in het zweet te werken. Once you have enrolled, you will need to participate and to pass. Want aanmelden is meedoen, is afmaken, want dat is het motto. Enroll, participate and pass, that's the motto. It's not just the university that is placing these demands, it's also our government and our society. Politics no longer accepts endless studies at universities. And that's why from today you will be confronted with the harde knip, die nare woorden allemaal, de harde knip, the bachelor before master rule. And after a fuzzy debate in The Hague, this is still the year of the langstudeerdersboete. Wat we er met z'n allen ook van mogen vinden. And talking about the government, as you all know, we have elections next week. There will be debates with candidates here on campus. So please go along and confront the politicians with your idea on education, on technology and innovation. Because, after all, you are the experts. Show them what we have accomplished in society through science and technology. And don't forget Europe. Show them what great things Europe has done for us and that we cannot and will not survive without Europe. In my opinion, it's your responsibility as scientists and engineers to participate in the political discourse, even when you're still a student. You have access to knowledge and insights that are important to share. Science is the best way to separate facts from fiction. It is the best antidote to fact-free sloganeering in the political debate. I won't try to influence your vote next week, but please, if you have the right to vote, use it. And vote for a party that promises to invest in higher education, in science and technology. But in the next 15 years, the Netherlands will run out of its natural gas. And once that is gone, once the gas is gone, knowledge will be the only raw material that we have for the future of our country. And only with the best possible education, we will be fit for the future. Dear colleagues, over there, this is going to be a particularly challenging year for everyone. Not only our students need to be in top form, us, as well. I know that many of our staff have spent a lot of time designing new courses and preparing themselves for the role of coach or mentor. That was a huge amount of work, an enormous effort. And all the other stuff didn't stop either. There was also the research and new project applications and the supervision of master and PhD students and much, much more. I sincerely appreciate your cooperation and creativity. Together we will put TU Eindhoven on the map even more firmly and become even more attractive to students. What we create this year together will determine the future of our university. And I wish you much inspiration in all these tasks. The Eindhoven engineer, that's what we are working for. And dear students, as you just heard, there is much to choose from, but there is even more. There are honors classes for talented students, and we have at TU Eindhoven a great Studium Generale, the best in the Netherlands. Again, there is a splendid program this fall. Again, there is a very inspiring lineup of speakers, starting this Wednesday, in 2 days, with a lineup of politicians. I strongly urge you to get involved. It's up to you to choose your own program, your own route, and make a success out of it. We do everything we can to help. Use the opportunities that we offer. Studying in Eindhoven will make you fit for the future. Let's make this a great year. Thank you.
Put it down again. I have to get used to this, I guess, today. Thank you very much again, Professor Hans van Duin. Thank you for offering us a clear overview of the Bachelor College, the Graduate School, and a lot of the other things that we can do at the university. And also thank you for motivating us to think clearly and work hard. We can really use that motivation. Thanks very much. Doodknuffelen, to be cuddled to death. As students at TUE, we are offered many opportunities to develop and learn. We are offered great, really incredible freedom in putting together our education program. One might say we are spoiled, or better say maybe we're lucky. We also have an abundance of opportunities to develop ourselves outside of our curricula. After graduation, we, the students, will experience how beneficial these opportunities are to us in industry. We'll also see that many more opportunities arise. Our next guest is an expert in industry, as our rector has already stated. We may see him as a visionary with an indisputable commitment to society and engineering. Please welcome President of Kiwi Niria, Martin van Pernis.
Ladies and gentlemen, at least your rector and I share the Rotterdam R. And I'm sure that Elke also has learned some things additional in Rotterdam. It's a great honor for me to be able to address to you today. And I'd like to thank the student committee who organized this opening of the academic year. And of course, for suggesting its theme, educational fitness. Professor Hans van Duin just presented the renewed curriculum to you, a program which is indeed a revolution in education, and which provides you with all the tools to be fit enough to kickstart your career. My congratulations with the Bachelor College and the new building, the Meta Forum. My compliments to everyone who is involved in this initiative. That includes the lecturers, researchers, the back office staff, the architect, It's precisely this cooperation between the various disciplines which is vital in the aspirations for success, whether that be in sports, in the academic world, or in practical engineering. And I especially want to talk about the practical side of things, the part that comes after the university education. The practical sides, which I've also experienced over the past 40 years, including being the CEO at Siemens Netherlands, and subsequently as a member of the board of various companies, and the president of the Royal Institute of Engineers, Kiviniria. I want to tell you about what you'll need to know about turning in what you have learned to be successful into really making it a success. Because, as you know, dreams and actions are separated by laws and practical objections. Tussen droom en daad staan wetten en praktische bezwaren. Those who recognize this poetic line from the marriage, het huwelijk, by Willem Elschot, will also know that these laws and practical objections caused death in the end. The central figure in the poem doesn't actually kill his wife. I can assure you, ladies and gentlemen, that the dreams and actions that I want to tell you about today are entirely of a different nature. They are certainly a lot less gruesome. This is about the actions for improving yourself, to get further, to jump higher, and to run faster. Indeed, to be fit. Even if you are not a sports fan, in some of the images that you have seen over the past few months, you'll obviously have noticed the urge to see dreams become reality, whether it was the European Football Championships, the Tour de France, or the Olympic Games. Sport is the embodiment of the terrific battle that men and women have with themselves, with their competitors, and with the elements. Success and failure often lie side by side. Even major successes from the past don't offer a guarantee for the future, as the Dutch national soccer team has demonstrated clearly. Perhaps you were also touched by Epke Zonderland's tears. The gold medal that he won in such a brilliant manner involved in a never been seen before combination of somersaulting elements. His success was preceded by major problems in the run-up to the games. There was even a jeopardizing moment that almost blew his chances of going to the games at all. That enormous amount of stress was showed during the tribute in the Ridderzaal. But it was also the case for the other medal winners and participants. They all had setbacks and all worked very hard, with many ups and downs, to realize their dreams. The I Dream campaign that was launched by your university in April was a beautiful way to not only portray the essence of the engineering profession and of sport, but of everything that's worthwhile in life. Not only the ability to be able to dream, but also to have the guts to dare to do so. Not to simply accept the bare facts, not to simply accept restrictions, but to visualize the final goal without any inhibitions. To know from deep down inside what it's really about. Higher, further, faster, better. Ladies and gentlemen, the challenges we are facing as engineers are enormous. Where can we find enough energy to see us through the next century? And how can we do that without causing any harm to the environment? How can we find sufficient raw materials to secure our insatiable need for products? And how do we ensure that our ever-aging population stays healthy and healthcare also remains affordable? Or the challenge of feeding a staggering 9 billion people in 2050, which is 2 billion more than today. Those are the challenges you will soon be faced with in practice. Those are the problems which you will need to resolve or for which you will develop solutions. But to be able to do that physically, you must not only have dreams or merely understand your profession, you will have to have another very important capability, one of an entirely different order. And you are the one who has to make the first move. It's your ambition and your dreams that form the fundamental base. But in getting that burning desire to develop in a successful fire, above all, you'll need to cooperate with other people. Cooperation is the oxygen for success and therefore of your career. It's the only thing that will enable you to successfully put your knowledge into practice. Global challenges, by definition, require a cross-sector, multidisciplinary approach. You will cooperate with other engineers, with other technical disciplines, but also with non-technical specialists, financiers, economists, psychologists, communication experts, and so on. The new education module at your bachelor college ties in very closely with this. I'd like to mention an example from my personal experience in my position as a member of the board of the Feyenoord Soccer Club. Just a simple example. We are negotiating the building of a new stadium with various parties. It's fantastic to see which disciplines come together to possibly create such a multi-million project. Aside from the many civil engineers, there are financiers, town planners, medical experts, but there are also media experts, behavior specialists, security organizations, and many more. Ladies and gentlemen, every project is multidisciplinary. Every development requires more disciplines. Where cooperation is concerned, you are in one of the most successful examples of the world. The region of Eindhoven has expanded because of cooperation. Eindhoven is the proof of a happy marriage between knowledge, money, and creativity, between education, the business community, and government. And that has an impact. You have served as an example for projects like the bioscience cluster in Leiden, and so too for the building campus, which is being established in the western part of the country. You are also in one of the best examples of cooperation within university walls. Amongst other things, this ensures that this university has again achieved the top ranking of all technical universities in the university selection guide for the 8th year in a row, while being the second best of all Dutch universities. 5 bachelor degrees are the best in their category. You probably know what they are, but I'll mention them anyway. Biomedical engineering, innovation science, industrial engineering and management science, chemical engineering and applied mathematics. The University of Technology Eindhoven is doing very well. And the new bachelor college is also evidence that top graders are never satisfied. They're always trying to better themselves. The new direction is an important step in the further development of the extraordinarily high level of education which this university has already achieved. More freedom in the making of personal choices go hand in hand with more responsibility. That combination is a precondition for optimum performances for any sport or activity whatsoever. Ladies and gentlemen, top athletes celebrate their successes. They do so via the media in our living rooms. Engineers don't do that. I'd rather say not yet anyway, because it's becoming more and more important that we make our successes public and celebrate them too. Knowledge and solutions alone don't always guarantee that they'll also be applied. The bigger the demand, the greater the social basis needed by politics and therefore also by the public is important. A social basis is essential. That's why it is essential that you put your dreams and actions into practice and show them to the world. Visibility is important. It's often said that engineers have a bad reputation. But I can assure you that doesn't make any sense at all. For quite a long time now, this elite's bad reputation has been used as the excuse while so few students have opted to study in the field of engineering and technology. But that was more a matter of not knowing than being unpopular. That's why it is so important that we propagate our profession. There are engineering and technology studies which cater for everyone's ambitions, personal motivations and interest. That's also part of the practice in which you'll soon be active. The aging of the population is also one of the reasons why there will be a shortage of well-educated engineers in the coming decades. You have already been wise in having chosen the field of technology. But that is being realized more and more by the public at large. Career opportunities are excellent. 80% of the graduates at the University of Technology clinch a job within a few months. And 100% of them do so within the first year. For the first time in years, there's an increasing interest in the engineering and technology studies. And you just heard the new figures from this university, from the rector. There's an ever-increasing number of players in your sport, so to speak. According to the Compass Study Choice, there are no less than 8 courses offered by the University of Technology in the top 20 of the favorite education choices by VWO, VWO boys and girls. Engineering and technology runs to the very core of our present-day society. People are becoming more and more aware of that. The rejected goal made by the Ukraine against England during the European Soccer Championships was the last straw for introducing the goal line technology. Wiggins' winning Sky team in the Tour de France has, more than any other team, also used scientific and technological improvements in its present-day professional cycling, which resulted in their outright supremacy. The limelight is continuously being shed on engineering and technology, so too in public media. Amongst other things, NRC Handelsblad published an article about the role of innovation in sport. Of course, the article mentioned the advanced start analyzer system which was developed in this city in Eindhoven. That's a system that has a major impact on the success of the Dutch swimmers and swimming teams. In the past weeks, all the media also reported on the flywheel for motor cars, which was developed at this university. Engineering improves performance. Your study, in the meanwhile, is well underway. Perhaps you are on the verge of going into praxis or starting a job. Or maybe you have only just started here. I want to tell all of you, don't look at only your own profession. An academic education such as the one you are getting here in Eindhoven is far more than just learning a subject, no matter how fundamental it is. A university education is all about developing yourself as a professional, but especially also as a person. It's particularly the latter from which you'll be able to gain the most in practice. I'd like to give you a simple advice. Don't overtrain yourself. Don't stare blindly at the engineering profession alone. No matter how much study pressure you may encounter, make time for other things. Later on in your career, they pay themselves back tenfold. Invest in yourself, whether there is a long-term study access fine or not. Take on management activities, for example. Become a club member. Practice sports physically, not only academically. Even if it takes an additional year. The network that you build now will be vitally important later in your career. But whatever you do, you'll understand that I, as the president of the Royal Institute of Engineers, Kiviniria, think you must absolutely, and without any doubt, immediately, right away, and rather today than tomorrow, become a member of the Royal Institute of Engineers. So I'm blatantly and shamelessly making use of this opportunity to advertise the oldest but mainly the most effective network in an engineering career. A combination of tradition and future. About 23,000 members have already connected one way or the other. Just like the influx in the engineering courses, the number of Kiviniria members is also rising. Our members find each other with the faculties, but also by way of more cross-sectoral connections. Like at a sports engineering department, which was established last year. That kind of reflective practice will also happen more and more in the forthcoming years. The importance of extracurricular networks have never been so great. Kiviniria offers them. Naturally, the association works hard on making engineering technology visible, as well as the managing of the sector's interest and all those who are employed by it. Some of you may already be aware that we have an successful career guidance program. But at the moment, we are also thinking of a form of graduation guidance. Every year we organize an Engineers' Day. And next week I will deliver the Techniek troonrede. Many of you have probably visited the CEO lectures, which we organized, not only here in Eindhoven, but also in Twente and Delft. We have also our annual congress every year, and this year the theme is healthcare and technology. This year in Twente, next year we will be here in Eindhoven. We are investing a great deal in making contacts with the press and politics. An engineering society like Kiviniria succeeds or fails dependent on the willingness of the engineers in supporting our activities. I am asking here for your support. In conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, I also have a dream. A dream of a flourishing engineering community. A dream of a world in which engineers not only take up the challenges of the next century, but also resolve them and propagate the solutions. We have to make sure that there's an adequate public support for the development of engineering techniques and for putting them into practice. You are the next generation who can do this, as a student, as a professor, or as a supporter. Be aware of this terrific task. And also be aware of the fantastic things that you could do in your career, of the difference that you could make in the life of others by using your knowledge and skills. You are at one of the best places to get and to give the right kind of education. All the necessary instruments and tools are here to achieve that. This calls for dedication, a willpower and a perseverance to get into the best condition to go out into the field, to catch your team to eventually soar to great heights. Your dreams of today will ensure that we'll continue to win the battle against flooding in the coming years, that we will stay healthy while growing old, and that the world has enough to eat. After all, when it comes to the major challenges faced by humanity, it's the engineer who forms the indispensable, unique link between dreams and actions. Het is de ingenieur die staat tussen droom en daad. Thank you very much and good luck.
Now it's the right height. Thank you very much, Mr. Van Pernis. I can assure you that we will never give up dreaming as a student, and I hope I speak on behalf of all the students here. I would also like to thank you for advising us on something very important, not to focus on only one muscle group, but not forget to train the whole body to become really fit. So I'd like to invite you also to come and join one of the gyms of the various student associations in Eindhoven. We're there for everybody to learn. Before we move on to the view on educational fitness of Mrs. Gerards, we'll enjoy the delightful, soothing voice of Steffi Ramakers. As for her performance today, I would like to share something very special with you. Steffi is a student of our university. She's an incredibly ambitious student and is currently doing an internship abroad in Chile. When she was asked to perform for you, she decided to take a 3-week leave and return to the Netherlands. I'm impressed by this devotion to her university, and I'm very curious to hearing her. I'm really looking forward. Supported by Marjan van Gansewinkel, study officer at the Communication Expertise Center, and Victor Dolk of the Student Music Association Quadrivium, for your enjoyment, Steffi Ramakers.
Thank you very much, Mike. Victor and I and Mayan will be playing two songs for you tonight. The first one is very dear to me, and it's also about dreaming. It's from Alicia Keys, and it's called New York.
I got a pocket full of dreams. Baby, I'm from New York. Concrete jungle where dreams are made of. There's nothing you can do. Hear it from New York. These streets will make you feel brand new. Bright lights will inspire you. Hear it from New York. Pot on the corner selling rock, preachers pray to God. Hail a gypsy cab, takes me down from Harlem to the Brooklyn Bridge. Someone sleeps tonight with a hunger for more than an empty I got a pocket full of dreams. Baby, I'm from New York. Concrete jungle where dreams are made of. There's nothing you can't do. Hear it from New York. These streets will make you feel brand new. Bright lights will inspire you. Hear it from New York. Big city, big dreams, bright lights all looking pretty. No place in the world I can compare. Put your lighters in the air, everybody say yeah, yeah, yeah.
May I please introduce to you Marjan van Ranswinkel.
Thank you.
And the next song we'll be performing is Wake Up by John Legend.
Wake up everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more backwards thinking. Time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There is so much hatred, war and poverty. Wake up all the teachers, time to speed a new land. I know you can do it if we all lend a hand. Cause there's still very much the world is in your hands. And the world is in your hand. I know we can.
Thank you very much. Music can really be a fantastic inspiration. Our final view on educational fitness today is offered by Mrs. Gerards, Associate Professor in Clinical Psychology at Erasmus University Rotterdam. Viva magazine voted her the smartest woman of the Netherlands, and she subsequently featured in the Dutch Current Affairs TV chat show, Pauwen Witteman. This charming appearance first caught our attention, but it is her vast knowledge of the human brain that had us invited to this stage. She will shine a light on what motivates you, and she will inspire you for this academic year. Please welcome Elke Gerards.
Much, Mike. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honor for me to speak to you this afternoon. I may have been elected the smartest woman of 2011 in the Netherlands, but of course that was luckily just for 1 year. Especially speaking here in the heart of one of the smartest regions in the world amid so many smart people makes me feel very humble. But today I'll try to show you how you can outsmart me. Being a psychologist, I can only applaud that your new bachelor's program now includes much more psychology. And that is not only because of the work it would give to me and my colleagues. Psychological knowledge is crucial to many fields and many developments in society. Psychology is not only crucial to marketing new products or designing technology with a built-in cognitive ergonomic. It's also essential in understanding the processes of cooperation in science and in understanding your own path through life. Leonardo da Vinci, the greatest engineer of all time, devoted considerable time to the study of the brain. He poured wax into skulls to see how the brain was connected to the nose and to the eyes, and he made very detailed drawings of the brain. He sketched the brain from many different perspectives, looking closely at the nerves and other connections. And the more Leonardo looked, the less he was sure about their function. One of his goals, along with most investigators of the brain at the time, was to locate the seat of the soul. And we still don't know. Intuitively, we immediately point to our hearts, the organ that makes our blood flow through the body. But speaking about our soul, we would have to point to another organ, namely the brain. This is the place for our thoughts, our feelings, our goals in life. When we fall in love, we only think in terms of the heart, but the love we cherish is in our brain. It's much the same way when after a major setback, we're sad. Actually, it is our brain that is sad. Our intentions, our dreams, our motivations, the being here together this afternoon, it's all here in our brain. All of us, we're sometimes limited by our brains. One person may be more intelligent than the next, but becoming the smartest woman of the Netherlands was not simply a matter of having a bigger or a better brain. It's also about how to use your brain. Your brain can sometimes become strained when we experience stress at work or during our study, or when we argue with our loved ones. Too often, people burn out, feel depressed or experience anxiety, more and more people becoming addicts. And the World Health Organization predicts that by 2020, depression will be the most common illness in the Western world, even above heart failure. These are all phenomena that distract us from the beautiful idea that we should live our lives with our heart and our soul. Becoming smart is also as much about coping with these kinds of adversity. Educational fitness, the theme of today, is not only about going to this beautiful gym, it's also about mental fitness. What if you could improve your brain just as you train and exercise your muscles? From psychological research, we know that you can. You can make your brain stronger through exercise. You can improve your performance and have much more awareness of life. Recent research in Stockholm shows that this is actually possible. Scientists in Torkel Klingberg's group gave people some computer exercises. They were exercises such as solving a Sudoku or a crossword puzzle, only slightly different. After 1 month, the people were not only better at these exercises, they were also better able to reason and to solve problems. And this was the case with young children, but even with adults over 65. Psychology has made tremendous progress since the days of Leonardo. We no longer need to dissect people to examine their brains. Klingberg and his colleagues used a scanner to see whether the brains of these people had changed. And the results were remarkable. They could see drastic changes in these brains, especially in their frontal lobe, located here, where much more connectivity was evident. These striking results have changed our ideas about the brain forever. No matter how old you are, you can always become smarter than you already are now. So I would be very happy to be outsmarted by all these smart women who I see here in the audience. Train yourself and become the smartest woman of 2013. Recently, in my research lab at the Erasmus University in Rotterdam, we examined whether the kind of training I just mentioned to you could have an effect on one's mental state. We tested people with depression and people with anxiety, and for a month they exercised their brains through computer training, a kind of mental gymnastics. The first results were very promising. Both the depressive and the anxious patients suffered less after this month of training. So brain training not only makes you smarter, it makes your brain apparently also more fit to cope with adversities in life. And that result is also important for people who do not suffer from mental illness. Because everyone, no exception here in this audience, will encounter setbacks in their lives. And resilient, courageous people who know how to handle the misfortune have an advantage in life. Indeed, a high IQ and a strong emotional intelligence are qualities that will make your life successful. But apart from these two, there's the third, often overlooked, an equally important quality, and that is one's resilience. Iemands veerkracht, one's stamina, one's determination to cope with setbacks, one's ability to stand up again after falling. It's a quality that has been admired and romanticized throughout centuries and in many different cultures. In fairy tales, for example, the handsome prince always had to go through a series of challenges before he could get to his princess. His best moments were when his resilience was tested to the limit, when the spring was fully stretched. Resilience is an essential common factor among successful people. You may be smart and you may be social with people, but a certain kind of determination and persistence is crucial on your road to success. In-depth interviews with successful people make that very clear. All of them succeeded through fighting back under exceptionally difficult personal or professional circumstances. What if you could exercise your resilience as well? What if you could increase your resilience? The good news is that resilience is not genetically determined. However, major events in our teens and in our 20s apparently have a huge impact on our resilience. An unstable and difficult childhood does not stain an individual for the rest of their life. A degree of turbulence is actually seeming to increase determination in your later life. Interviews have revealed that the majority of successful people experienced a troubled childhood. They came from broken homes or had to deal with childhood trauma, such as the death or alcoholism of a parent. So it is important, ladies and gentlemen, to give misfortune its place. It prepares you for future adversity, even if it threatens like dark clouds overhead. And it's important to realize that I'm not talking just soft psychology. Resilience is a concept that is used in many natural sciences and technology. It describes the way a system can cope with shocks. Let's take, as an example, the stability of ecosystems. For decades, we've been speaking about sustainability, about restoring equilibrium, about the conservation of species. But now we're becoming aware that ecosystems are seldom in equilibrium and are beaten from one extreme to another by ever-changing circumstances. There's a whole new branch of mathematics which calculates how food chains, or rather food networks, survive shocks. It shows which species are important for the resilience of an ecosystem. The Stockholm Resilience Institute, for example, does just this kind of research. Its analysis shows which aspects of an ecosystem are crucial for its survival. And this kind of analysis requires hard mathematics and complex computer models. Much the same is true for our financial system. It's very telling that a director of the British Central Bank published a paper in the magazine Nature, together with an ecologist from Oxford, about the resilience of the financial system. They have left behind the classical notions of Adam Smith about equilibrium and markets. Instead, markets are shaken by crashes and bubbles. And the essence of resilience lies in the connections of banks. Lehman was not a big bank. It was not too big to fail, but it was too connected to fail. In much the same way, psychologists are looking for the core of resilience in our brains. And that is, of course, much more complicated than the analysis of an ecosystem or a financial market. Our brain is a network of a trillion neurons, so we will need some time for that research. Anticipation is very important for our resilience. And that is not so much different from the financial system I just spoke about. Regulators should pay extra attention to banks that are too connected to fail, requiring extra financial buffers, for example. In much the same way, we should take care of the essence of our own resilience. Anticipating failure or a difficult situation is, in fact, the most effective way to beat it. Anticipation is the active ingredient that enables us to stay on track. It takes courage and leadership. You need initiative to anticipate and to be resilient. Initiative to live your life with heart and soul and to intervene when something has gone wrong or is about to go wrong. Without your own initiative, you will be engrossed in the issues of the day, the tasks of the week, the delusion of the month, or the illusion of even years. The new bachelor's college offers much for you to choose. The flexibility in the program makes the choice entirely yours. You should grasp that opportunity. You are the ones who have to make the bold choices in the coming years. If you're swept away with the issues of the day, you'll get the delusion of the year, and in the end, you'll be nowhere. You need to be active, to plan your way, and anticipate the consequences of it. As the director already said, enroll, participate, and pass. Aanmelden is meedoen is afmaken. I completely agree with that sentiment. You need to make your choices with your eyes wide open. What major will I choose? Will I specialize or do I want a broad education? Are you going to be the next Leonardo or an Einstein? It's you who must decide. And that is not only true for the grand plan of your study, it's also true on a much smaller scale. Am I going to study all night tonight, or do I immerse myself in a pub? I'm of course not saying that you shouldn't go to the pub, but anticipating what you'll encounter in both choices will make you smarter and more responsible, and therefore better prepared for your career. And that is not only a message to the students, much the same is true for the staff here present. Progressing on the path of science requires stamina and resilience. That's what I also experienced as a psychologist. I've been at important crossroads in my life. After studying in Maastricht, I went to Harvard University in the States and St. Andrews in Scotland. They're the absolute top in the world for me, and it made me much smarter being there. But somehow, I felt that they weren't the right choice for the time ahead, especially in Scotland, where I missed the open spirit of continental Europe. And I anticipated that I would be much happier if I could return to the Netherlands. It's quite strange to say as a Belgian. It was really the right thing to do, though. This new start has contributed much to my resilience and thus to my professional success. That, of course, doesn't mean that my career was easy after that step. You still have to engage in discussions and fight opposition, and sometimes you feel like you're being done wrong, which might be quite sleep-depriving. But even then, you can be the captain of your own soul, as long as you anticipate, cherish your resilience, and take setbacks as a fact of life. They will strengthen you. Study and live your life as a student with your heart right in it. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope that this message will take roots in your brains, and that you realize that the initiative lies in your own hands. Let yourself be guided by your brain, but also lead your brain. For the staff, it's always necessary to renew yourself and question the chosen path. And for the students, these are the crucial years in your lives, which will determine your future. Seize all opportunities and do so mindfully. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Gerard. I sincerely hope that our students and staff will take your advice to heart and that they will be active and very, very resilient. Now, the pursuit of top shape would have little meaning if we did not take a moment to reflect on the quality that our university offers. So let us honor those lecturers that are able to reach the hearts and souls of their students and inspire them throughout their educational programs. Please welcome once again to the stage our rector, Hans van Duyn.
Educational awards, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much, Mike. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to present the awards for the best lecturer in the TU Eindhoven bachelor's programs and for the best lecturer in the TU Eindhoven master programs. So two awards. Good education is crucial, clearly, and should be rewarded, and good lecturers deserve to be put in the spotlight. This is the fifth time our university has done this during the opening of the academic year, so by now it is a well-established tradition. The procedure was as follows. Our students nominated one lecturer for each bachelor's program and one lecturer for each master's program. A jury then assessed the nominations, and the jury was made up of representatives of the study associations that worked together through the SRO, the Student Advisory Body, with Karin Ali from STU and myself offering guidance. And the jury members had the extremely difficult, indeed almost impossible task of selecting the winners from among the outstanding lecturers who were nominated. Let's start with the bachelor lecturer. The following colleagues were nominated for the best bachelor's lecturer at Eindhoven University of Technology in the academic year 2011-2012. And I will read out their names in alphabetic order, and mind you, these are the nominees. I will announce the winner in a moment. Helene Aerts, Paul van der Bos, Pieter van Gorp, Gert-Jan van Heist, Kees Huizing, Geert Langerijs, Kees Omens, Georg Prokert, Lambert Royakkers, Piet Schreurs en Alex van der Ven. And these are the nominees for the Bachelor Award. And I won't keep you in suspense, ladies and gentlemen. The best bachelor lecturer at Eindhoven University of Technology in the academic year 2011-2012 is Professor Gert-Jan van Heist from the Department of Applied Physics. Gert-Jan. It's a coincidence you're here, Gert-Jan. Very good. Zo, kom er even bij staan. Deze kom. Right, the field of Professor van Heist is fluid mechanics, and that is the topic he teaches. I know that he's very much engaged in setting up a brand new and exciting course for the first year physics students. But the jury, the students, judged him based on a course that you gave last year. Gert-Jan, let me read from the jury report. Professor van Heist is great at giving appealing examples for everything he explains. He includes questions from the National Science Quiz, the Nationale Wetenschapsquiz, in his lectures in such a way that the students themselves come to the conclusion that the official answers are not always correct. Vaak heel moeilijk te volgen, die quiz. He encourages students to think critically. Gert-Jan, that sounds really an ideal starting position for our new bachelor college. But there is more, ladies and gentlemen. Over the past 4 years, Gert-Jan van Heist got an 8.3 average mark from the students, and that is very high. And furthermore, Professor van Heist actively participated in task force number one, the task force that came with the original idea to form a bachelor college. Gert-Jan, thank you very much, and congratulations.
Even een beetje uit het midden, hè, voor de foto.
Oh, voor de foto. Even. Ja. Yes? En dan heb ik nog een oorkom.
Alsjeblieft.
Kan je even helpen aan Annelies, want het is te veel.
Het is te veel van goed.
Zal ik hier bij gaan houden?
Dankjewel.
All right, we now move on to the best lecturer at Eindhoven University of Technology on the master level in the academic year 2011-2012. Ladies and gentlemen, the nominees are Martijn Antonissen, Mark de Berg, Mikael Bruns Alonso, hang on, Bernard Kolenbrander, Antal Haans, Maarten Merks, Ed Nijssen, Hans Kuipers, Edgar Vredenbrecht, Siep Weiland en Nathan van der Wouw. Those are the nominees. And the winner, the best master's lecturer at Eindhoven University of Technology in the academic year 2011-2012 is Maarten Merks. Maarten. Ah.
Jullie zullen er kijken.
Leuk, hè? Ja. Huh? Maarten, this is what the jury... Maarten is associate professor, UHD, at the Department of Biomedical Engineering, and he works in the Protein Engineering Group. Correct?
Correct.
Maarten, this is what the jury has written. Maarten Maddox often asks questions in his lectures, and he really encourages students to answer them. Because his lectures are closely linked to his own research, he shows his students what is going on in the forefront of research. Maarten also gets his students to select and present scientific papers. During those presentations, he stimulates discussions in a relaxed atmosphere. It says here, chillin' with science. And Maarten gives bonus points to students who come up with good critical questions. Maarten Maddox is not afraid to admit when he doesn't know the answer. That's a good, eigenschap, for property. Because when that happens, he promises his students that he will look into it, and he always does. Maarten, congratulations with this very nice assessment. Okay. Annelies, help je even mee? Ja. Oké. All right. Ga je zitten, Maarten? Goed zo. Dear Gert, Jan and Maarten, I have yet another little present, a second additional surprise. And that is the following, that the board of the university invites you to for a flight in our hot air balloon. That is spectacular. And mind you, it's not here this afternoon, but somewhere in the near future. I don't know how it is with the weather. And I hope you're not afraid of heights. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now approaching the end of the official part of this academic session. And before I conclude, a couple of words of gratitude. First of all, I would like to thank our Master of Ceremonies, Mike Wilmer. You did it very well, Mike, a compliment. And your team for organizing this gathering and this evening events. You all have done a great job, and your hard work has really paid off. Thank you very much. I would like to thank Martin van Pernis for coming to Eindhoven and for his interesting story, and many thanks as well to Elke Geraerts for her inspiring speech, Educational Fitness Indeed. Before I proceed to the official opening of the academic year, I would like to invite you, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the board of the university, to our traditional reception. And as always, there are two options. One is, they're both in our superb new building, the Meta Forum. The party is downstairs with a lot of music and a DJ, and a lot of fun, and there is a quieter get-together on the first floor. And if you follow us, and we will follow the music, then everything will be okay. Thank you all for coming. Time now for the official opening of the academic year 2012-2013. And I have to hit the red button. Oké. Hierbij verklaar ik het academisch jaar 2012-2013 geopend.